Hey everybody, welcome in. My name is Ernest and I'm gonna teach you how to cook. Today, it's one of those fantastic one pot meals. It is pasta e ceci, or pasta cheech, depending where you live. It's pasta and chickpeas. It's all in one pot. It's a whole lot of delicious. It's very Italian and I think you're gonna kinda dig it. In the extra helping, it's a really good dessert. It's peach dumplings. You won't believe what goes into this dish and how good it is when it comes out. All of that in this show, so let's get going. This is Eating in Bed. So as you know, or may not know, my roommate is Italian. He's hardcore Italian. His parents are Italian. He's got that long last name when his ancestors came over on the boat. There's a lot of Italian going on around here, and I'm from the Mid-South, so our cooking cultures kind of clash, but yet they've blended rather well over the years. One of the things that he makes sometimes is pasta fagioli, which is a pasta with beans in it. And it's not unusual in Italian culture to make that, but it's not a favorite for me. At all. I don't eat it. It's not that it's not tasty, I just don't like the idea of those two things together. But then recently I was looking around and I found this recipe for pasta e ceci, which is pasta and chickpeas, literally. It's a very quick dish. It's something that you can literally pull from your pantry and cook in about 30 minutes or so. It's a 30 minute meal. And it's really tasty. And I thought, you know what? I'm gonna give this a try. I think I might like it. And I think you might too. So like any good Italian dish, it's gotta have a little pork in it. Now, the original recipes call for pancetta, which is a cured bacon, but it's not smoked. I'm actually using regular smoked bacon today because I love the flavor of it. If you have pancetta, cut it into about half inch cubes. You're gonna need about 2 ounces by weight, of course. And I just chopped up some bacon and I'm gonna put it right in the food processor because you want this to kind of render down in the pan. You're not gonna have, you're not gonna have big pieces of bacon or pancetta in there. So I'm gonna put the bacon in here first and pulse it for about 30 seconds. And you want it to really break down. It's almost gonna be like a paste because when you cook it, you want it to just kind of disappear and flavor the pasta e ceci. So I'm gonna pulse it here for about 30 seconds and just make it really, really fine. Now I want you to take a look at this real quick. You see how that's really just broken up? There's practically nothing in it. So, you can't tell it's bacon. It's just a bunch of chopped up stuff. So I'm gonna put that back on my food processor and I'm gonna add that one stalk of celery or rib of celery. I grabbed a really thick one and I put a few extra fronds in it as well, which is the leafy parts on top. And then the carrot. Now you're gonna pulse this about 10 times because you really want this chopped up really fine as well. You don't want really big chunks of this in your pasta e ceci. So give it 8 to 10 really good pulses. So I've got a really good texture to that. I have 4 cloves of garlic that I'm gonna add in here as well and give that a really fine pulse as well. Now into that, we're gonna add 1 onion. I had a really big white onion, so I'm literally just using half of the onion, cut it into, chunks, because you don't want the onion to process quite as much as you want everything else to process. So you're gonna put this in last and just chop it to where you get little bitty pieces. You don't want it really fine like everything else. So maybe 6 to 8 pulses, depending on your food processor. So that is done and that's what it should look like. Everything's very finely chopped up and minced. And I'm gonna put that right in a cold pot, actually. You don't have to turn the heat on before. And there's a reason for that. You really want the bacon to slowly render down. If you put it in a hot pot, it could burn. It could cook a little too fast before your vegetables cook. And you really don't want that at all. So put it in a pot that's not over a fire. We're gonna put it on about a medium fire here in just a sec. All right, that is the basis for a lot of good stuff. So let me turn the fire on and then add a quarter cup of olive oil right to this. And you're going to let that cook about 5 minutes. You don't want the vegetables to really brown. You're just trying to soften them up, but you really want that bacon or pancetta in there to cook down and get a little bit of color on the bottom of your pan, because as we all know, that fond that forms on the bottom of your pot, that is flavor, and that's what we want. So about 5 minutes for this. So in a minute, we're gonna need some tomatoes for this, obviously. And here I have 14 ounces of whole tomatoes. Now, of course, they come in a juice or a sauce, and I drain that off. You don't want a lot of extra liquid in here. This is probably just a scooch over 14 ounces, but it's going to work down. Now, you can put this in your food processor and process this. You want it kind of nicely chopped. You don't want it pureed. I have an immersion blender, and I like to go in here with that. You can kind of squish them first, but then just hit low and do little pulses in here and give it a good chop. And see, when I'm done, right at 14 ounces. So if you're doing it in a cup, dry or without the juice, I should say, you're gonna hit about 16 ounces, but when you process it down, it'll be 14. Now, we took the juice out of that because we don't want a really wet soup stew thing that we're making here. We want it to be a little drier, for lack of a better word. So take out that extra juice. You're gonna have juice in the tomato, of course, but the juice around them, take that out. I just spooned them out with a huge spoon that had holes in it, shook off all that extra sauce, and I just left them in here until I'm ready to use them, and it worked great. Okay, so the vegetables and the bacon have cooked down, and don't be surprised if you get a little water in your pan. Remember, onion, celery, and carrot all have water in them, so when you put it in there, they're going to come out. So just keep cooking and stirring until that cooks down. It's gonna be a relatively dry pan. I'm starting to get a little fond on the bottom. You don't want the vegetables to brown. You just want them to cook down a little bit. So you got a little bit of fond in the bottom of the pond there. Bottom of the pan. Oh, it's good stuff, good stuff. All right, let's add some more flavors to this. I'm gonna do a quarter teaspoon of red pepper flakes, because you always need a little bit of heat there. 2 teaspoons of fresh rosemary. Don't use dry in this case. Rosemary is in season. You definitely wanna use fresh for this. Just give it a nice mince. Oh, that's so good. And finally, 2 teaspoons of anchovy paste. If you have an anchovy, you can use that. Just rinse it and mince it really fine. But I'm gonna use anywhere from 1 to 2 teaspoons of anchovy paste. Now, you think it's gonna be fishy, but it's really not. Anchovy paste just gives a nice meaty flavor, puts a little extra salt in it. 2 little teaspoons, anchovy paste comes in these tubes, which is really great. And you can just put it right back in the fridge when you're done with it. Let that cook in. Oh, you can smell that anchovy. It doesn't smell fishy, it just smells nice and meaty. It's good. At this point, you wanna go ahead and add those chopped tomatoes that you had. Remember, they were whole tomatoes. We put about 16 ounces, which is 2 cups here, and then with an immersion blender, chopped them down, and we have right about 14 ounces. You can do that in your food processor too. Don't puree it. You still want a little bit of texture to it here. Look at that, building the sauce. You'll notice that we're not using any stock or anything. We're actually kind of building one on our own here, and I'll show you how in just a minute. And this right here, when you're in here, take a minute, and those tomatoes, because of the acidity, you can actually deglaze any of the little fond on your pan that you might have. And now we need 2 15-ounce cans of chickpeas. And normally you would drain them, but here we're actually gonna use the canning liquid, which is just water. That's how chickpeas are cooked. That's gonna help build your natural stock in this, your natural broth. So 2 15-ounce cans, they might say 15 and a half, or they might say 14 and 3/4 or something like that, but 2 normal-sized cans of chickpeas, water and all. And finally, to push this along with the broth, 2 cups of water. Right, look at that. Look at that. And then we're gonna do 1 teaspoon of salt right in here. Things that are really starchy really kind of need some extra help when it comes to seasonings and flavoring. So don't be afraid to put a little salt in your pasta dishes. Now, what we're gonna do is bring this to a boil and then drop it to a simmer. And we're gonna cook it about 10 minutes or so. You wanna give those chickpeas a head start to kind of soften and break down. You don't want them really crunchy in your pasta ecce. That is looking really good. So I've got the heat turned up. I'm gonna bring it to a boil and immediately drop it back down to a vigorous lower simmer. You don't want it really boiling a lot. You want it to cook down and reduce a little bit, and then we're gonna put the pasta in there. You don't want all the water to go away, so keep an eye on your simmer, and then we're gonna put the pasta in, and then we're in the home stretch at that point. Okay, it has been 10 minutes and this has been nicely simmering away. Now let's put the pasta in. Now what I have here to the side is my little scale, and I'm gonna measure out 8 ounces of ditalini. Now you wanna measure by weight. 8 ounces is about, you know, a cup or a cup and a half, wherever you wanna go with it. But you really need to measure in weight because pasta can be different sizes. I mean, you could have 8 ounces of pasta, and if it's a big shell, you might only have 6 shells or something, or 8 shells. So you want to measure out. I measure by grams. 8 ounces is about 233 grams. So I'm just going to go right here. I know you can't see it. 239 or 240. That's a little too much. 234. Perfect. Ditalini is a nice small pasta here, but you do want 8 ounces by weight. And these kitchen scales are under $20. I will actually put a link in the description below in the caption of the one I use. It's really simple. And this great little bowl fits right on top. You turn it over and put it on top and it stores easily. Isn't that great? So 8 ounces of pasta right in there. Here, let me show you this real quick. This is the scale. Turn it off. And you can go metric or imperial right there. And when you're done with this that fits on top, you just put it like that and you store it. How about that? So you're gonna put the pasta in here, 8 ounces. Look at that, it's gonna get nice and starchy. And you're gonna simmer this for 10 more minutes. Kind of make sure it's rolling. Start your timer, 10 minutes. Stay tuned because we're gonna take a break, but in the extra helping, I'm gonna show you how to make those peach dumplings. They are so easy and so delicious. I filmed this about a week ago. And my roommate and I dug into it and it lasted about 2 days. That's how good it is. Almost tastes like a cobbler. I love fruit dishes like that at room temperature. I don't like them hot. You can eat it hot if you want to, let it cool just a little bit. Eat it warm, eat it cold, eat it at room temperature. We had some French vanilla ice cream with it. My goodness. And you can do any kind of frozen fruit with this. You could do mango slices because they're in season. You could probably do pineapple if you wanted. You won't believe the extra ingredient it's got in it. It seems so bizarre, but when it's done, it is so good. Stay tuned, you're gonna see that right now. When we come back, it's gonna be 10 minutes later, and this pasta ecce is going to be done, and we're gonna taste it, and dinner's on. I'll see you right after this.
At the Olive Garden Italian restaurant, we speak a different language. We have no words for can't and won't. No phrases for a little less. In fact, we don't know the meaning of enough. Some would say speaking a different language can make all the difference in the world. The Olive Garden Italian restaurant, where all the best of Italy is yours. Come back for the endless refills of salad and garlic breadsticks that make us special.
To start, you need 2 packages of crescent rolls from the refrigerator section. Each one has 8 crescent rolls. And you're also gonna need a 16-ounce package of frozen peach slices. You can find those in the freezer section of your grocery store. Take 1 portion of crescent dough and lay it out flat. Then take 1 slice of a peach and starting at the long end of the crescent roll, roll the peach in the dough. Place it in a buttered 9x13 baking dish. You can just take a little bit of butter and rub it in your pan with your fingers. Continue until you use up all 16 pieces of crescent dough. Line them up in the pan so they look good.
Here I have 7 in 2 different rows, and I put the 2 extras in the middle perpendicular. Once you're done with that, set it to the side. In a saucepan over medium heat, melt 3/4 cup of butter. Add 1 cup of sugar and 1/4 cup of brown sugar. Keep that over a medium heat, whisking it almost constantly until the sugar melts. It will be a thicker, grainier mixture. Turn the heat off and add 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract and 1 teaspoon of amaretto liqueur. You can use bourbon or whiskey if you want. And add 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Mix that together. Now pour the butter mixture over the crescent rolls and peaches in your baking dish. Make sure everything is nice and covered. Next, sprinkle cinnamon over all of the dumplings. You're going to use 1.5 to 2 teaspoons total. If you use a little bit more, that's fine. Next, you're going to add 1 can, which is 12 ounces of a lemon lime soda, like Sprite or 7-Up or whatever brand you find. Don't pour it directly on the dumplings. You don't want to wash the cinnamon off. Pour it around the perimeter and between the dumplings. Preheat your oven to 350 degrees and bake this for exactly 40 minutes. When it's done, the dumplings are very hot, so let it sit for about 5 to 10 minutes to cool down. You can eat these hot, at room temperature, or cooled down totally. They're delicious with a little vanilla ice cream or whipped cream on top, or just as you see them here. And those are peach dumplings. Enjoy!
Oh my goodness, it's been 10 minutes. Look at this pasta. Let me turn the heat off on this right now. Oh, look at that. All that ditalini, just 8 ounces by weight. I keep saying that because it's important. Has soaked up that excess liquid. Oh, look at that. The chickpeas, and what's great about this is the ditalini and the chickpeas are kind of the same size, so you don't have anything weird floating around on your spoon. When you pick it up, you're gonna get everything equally, and that's actually really nice. Mmm, let's serve this up. Now, actually, what you wanna do here is add about a table of fresh cut parsley. Don't use dried parsley, use fresh parsley, the flat leaf. About a tablespoon, and about a tablespoon of fresh lemon juice, not juice out of a jar. And I've cut the end off a lemon here, which is just gonna give me right about what I need. That adds a little bit of green to it, and the lemon juice adds a little bit of brightness to it. It's not gonna be a lemony dish, so don't worry about it. And now let's just serve this up. I've got a huge bowl here, so I'm just gonna get a good ladle of it right there. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Mmm. Look at that. And then I have a little bit of Parmesan cheese here. That's nice. Now, before you serve this up, you do want to check for salt and pepper. I tasted just the broth from it a couple minutes ago, and it was good. But check it for salt and pepper, and look at that. You could actually do a little drizzle of olive oil on there if you wanted to as well. Some chopped green onion or scallion would be really nice on there as well. Let's give it a taste, though. Oh, my goodness gracious. Look at that. Just nice. I don't know. Is it a soup? Is it a stew? Is it just a pasta dish? I mean, this is not just a pasta dish, let's be clear. Holy smokes. Okay, let's talk about what's going on here. The starch from the ditalini and the chickpeas have really thickened it up. The tomatoes cooked down a little bit. Oh, that bacon and anchovy flavor, you can't tell it's in there, but there's something just kind of deep and rich about the whole thing. And the chickpeas are really soft. I do not like chickpeas, but that's good stuff. I don't think you can go wrong with that. So I encourage you to try this next time. These are items that are actually in your pantry. Most everybody has chickpeas, they have some herbs. Give the video a thumbs up, let me know. Leave me a comment below and let me know if you've ever made this and if you changed it up and what your kind of, you know, little twist on it is. Click subscribe so you don't miss anything, and I will see you next time. I appreciate you watching. Ooh, and enjoy those peach dumplings too. I told you those were good. I'll see you next time. Bye.